Hi, my name is Jemima Allen. I'm a medical student at Monash University, Melbourne, undertaking my Bachelor of Medical Science honours year at the Oxford Uehiro Centre for Practical Ethics. So, have you ever had to give consent to an operation before? What was that like? Normally, you might expect to have a brief chat with a junior doctor on the morning of an operation before signing a consent form and being whisked off to surgery. One of the biggest challenges with the current consent process is that often doctors don't have enough time to go through all the relevant information with patients.
It's common in our health system and many around the world when patients are going to have an operation for the conversation about the procedure and taking consent formally to be delegated. That means somebody else, not the surgeon, has that conversation, records on a form or piece of paper the patient's consent. But there are challenges. Challenges because the person taking the consent may not have experience of the procedure, they may be short on time, they may not know the patient themselves. And so that means that those conversations are not always what we would want them to be.
Imagine this time instead, your doctor has sent you a link to an app called Consent-GPT. This app is like a virtual AI-generated surgeon, and it allows you to ask it as many questions as you like about the operation, and it will give you up-to-date and medically accurate responses tailored to your clinical situation. You might have heard of large language models like ChatGPT. One possible application of this technology is to use it to provide patients with up-to-date and detailed information before an operation and signing a consent form. Together with my co-authors, Professor Dominic Wilkinson, Dr. Julian Copland, and Dr. Brian Earp, I've recently had a paper called Consent-GPT accepted for publication in the Journal of Medical Ethics. We discussed the idea of using large language models to improve patients' decision-making and understanding in the consent process, as well as allow doctors to spend more time in meaningful dialogue with their patients. The use of this technology in medical consent sparks ethical debate, particularly in relation to who will be responsible if or when things go wrong, and the importance of information accuracy when providing consent to patients.
How would we know that, or how could we be sure that this type of program would provide accurate information to patients?
Well, while it's true that current versions are prone to giving misleading and sometimes even false responses, it's likely that future versions will be more accurate, and human oversight can monitor and improve their responses, a process which currently isn't possible with junior doctors. Other concerns that people might have, which we discuss in more detail in the paper, include medical accuracy of large language models, patient data privacy, and trust in medical AI. Future research might look into public and professional acceptance of this technology in medical consent. If large language models are found to be better than current practices at seeking consent from patients, then it might be an ethical imperative for future doctors to use this technology.